Now start today the mathematical reasoning, that is logic. Now it's natural science is real science only in so far it is mathematical. So why logic? So mathematical reasoning, we apply the rules of mathematics. So mathematics is correct. So mathematics is correct proof means by correct argument. So it is essential in mathematics we know which actual means the argument is correct. The argument is correct or argument is not correct, it is depend upon the mathematical reasonings, or that means logics. So in this way we know some points in reasoning, or that is statement. That is statement. Statement or proposition. Statement or proposition. So what is statement? What do you mean by statement? In which condition a sentence is called a statement? So statement or proposition is a sentence which have truth values, either true or false, but not both. If any sentence which is either true or false is called a statement. It's called a statement. So any sentence which is either true or false is called a statement. Statement is a declarative sentence. That means in sentence we have to see whether it is true or false. As for example, suppose we write that Bhubaneswar is the capital, of Odisha. Bhubaneswar is the capital of Odisha. Now in this sentence we see that it is always true. So the truth value of the sentence is true. Then this sentence is called a statement or proposition. As this sentence possesses the truth value true. Now write to another sentence that 3 divides 17. 3 divides 17. It is false. So this sentence is called a statement. Now write another example that Navin Patnaik is CM of Andhra Pradesh. Now this sentence is always false. If a sentence is true or false, then the sentence is called a statement. So these are the example of a statement. Sun rises in east, so it is a statement. Sun rises west, it is also a statement. If you write sun rises west, its truth value is false, so it is a statement. If you write sun rises east, so it is a statement, as it has truth value true. So when you write a statement, we have to see whether the sentence possesses truth values. Now any statement has truth values. Any statement have truth values. If a sentence possesses truth values, then we say it is called a statement. Now, every sentence does not occur the truth values. As for example, I say, what is your name? What is your name? Where are you going? Where are you going? Is 5 greater than 7? Now write some interrogative sentences. First we write what is your name. So we cannot say it is true or we cannot say it is false. Where are you going? We cannot say it is true or it is false. Is 5 greater than 7? We cannot say it is true or false. Here we write it is true. 5 greater than 7? Is 5 greater than 7? We write yes or no. So we cannot write true or false. What is your name? We say my name is Gita or Sita or Gopal or myself is Ramesh. But you cannot say it is true or false. So all interrogative sentences are not example of a statement. As here we cannot see that it has truth values. Again, I write another statement. May God bless you. May God bless you. May God bless you. So here we see, we cannot write, it is true. So God, we cannot say, hey, it is true or it is false. It is blessing is depend upon God. So firstly we cannot say, it is always true. Hence, this type of sentence, we cannot write, say it is a statement. As it has no truth values. Now another statement. Oh, how fine weather it is. Oh, what is a beautiful scenery it is. Oh, what is a beautiful flower it is. Oh, what is a beautiful flower it is. How fine the weather it is. So in this type of sentence, we cannot say it is true or it is false. Hence, all interrogative sentences, all exclamatory sentences, blessing sentences are not example of statement. As we cannot write true or false. Now, we write another statement. That is, come here, come here, go there. Now this is oral sentences or command statements sentences, state forward, state backward. So command statement, oral sentence, we say come here. So we cannot write it is true or we cannot write it is false. Come here means we write yes or no. So we cannot say it is true or false. Hence, these sentences are not belongs to a statement. As we cannot write, we cannot say its truth values. As it does not possess the truth values, hence it is not a statement. Now I say another example. That is, x plus 10. Greater than 5. Here we cannot say this true as it contains a variable x. We does not know the value of x. We does not know the value of x. X is a variable which varies by putting the numbers. If you write x is equal to 1, so 11 is greater than 5, it is true. If you write x is equal to 0, so 10 is greater than 5, it is true. If you write x is equal to minus 20, So it is not greater than 5. So it is this truth value of this sentence depend upon the value of x, which is a variable. Now, so we cannot write it is true or false, as it contains a variable x. So sentences containing variables a, b, c, d, x, y, z are not example statement. Suppose a question is written as x plus 10 greater than 5, where x is known, x is equal to 1. So it is true. If the value of x is known, then we say it is true. Then truth value is just. If truth value is just, so the sentence is a statement. Now say another example that today is Sunday. So we cannot write that it is true. Suppose today is Sunday and the next day is Monday. So today, tomorrow, yesterday, these are linked with dates. These are refer for dates. If a date is not assigned, so we cannot say it is true. Suppose the question is written that today that is 7/8/20 is Wednesday. So write it is true or it is false, as it is referred to a date. So we remember that sentences containing today, tomorrow, yesterday, but not mentioning the date is not a statement. Yesterday I do this problem. So we are in confusion. Every day we say yesterday we do this problem, yesterday we do this problem, as we are not mentioning a date, so it is a confusion. So the sentences containing today, tomorrow, yesterday, if date is not mentioned, so it is not a statement. Now say another example, that is Kashmir is far from here. Kashmir is far from here. We are in confusion. Then where it is far? Here means it is represent for a place, but a place is not written. So place is not mentioned. So Kashmir is far from Bhubaneswar. Kashmir is far from Cuttack. Kashmir is far from Nayar. Kashmir is far from Bombay. It is not mentioned. Hence we cannot say it is true. If we say it is true, the student of Kashmir is right, it is false. Hence there is a confusion. Since here and there, a sentence containing here and there, not mentioning the place, is not example of a statement. Now you see another example, that C is a mathematics lecturer. So we cannot say it is true. C, he are represent for a person. He is a chief minister. Then we cannot write he means who. Suppose we write Navin Patnaik is chief minister of Orissa. In place of Navin Patnaik, we write he is chief minister of Orissa. So we are in confusion. So he, she, they are placed by a person. If a sentence containing he, she, not write its name or person, so it is not a example of a statement. Again, we see that a statement is not judged by any yardstick. Is not judged by any yardstick. Suppose you write that Bhubaneswar Bhubaneswar is a big city. Bhubaneswar is a big city. Hence, we cannot write it is true or false. The word big is not well defined. So, well defined means that is a yardstick. Yardstick means the big word must be defined. So, data is given, a city became a big city if its population is 1 lakh. It contains a collector, SP, and 2 plus 3 colleges, 10 plus 2 colleges. If this criteria, this yardstick are fulfilled, any city, that is a big city. And data of Bhubaneswar is given. Bhubaneswar population 2 lakhs. Here Bhubaneswar are a collector, SP, plus 3 college, plus 2 college. Are they satisfy the all conditions of a big city? So it is a big city. As the big word is not well defined, we write the coconut tree is a big tree. So how can you say the coconut tree is a big tree? The word big is not well defined. Big tree means that data is given. If a tree is a big tree, that must be height 25 foot and the coconut tree has length 30 foot. If it is given, so it is true. If it is given that coconut tree length is 15 foot, so it is false. So if it is true or false, we say it is a statement. So we know that a statement, what is a statement? A statement means it is a sentence possessing truth values, either true or false. If it does not possess a truth value, so we cannot say it is a statement. So which sentences are not belongs to a statement? That is number one, that not a statement, not a statement, not a statement. Number one, all interrogative sentences, all interrogative sentences, they are not example of a statement. All exclamatory sentences are not example of a statements. All sentences, all order, command, blessing, wish. So these sentences, order sentence, come here, command sentence, come forward, come backward, blessing, may God bless you, or wish. This type of sentences are not example of a statement. Next, sentences containing variables, that is A, B, C, X, Y, Z, like this. If the sentences containing variables A, B, C, X, Y, Z, like this, that is not a statement. Next, sentences is not judged by any yardstick. Sentences are not judged by any yardstick. But it has no yardstick where we judge it is a statement or not. Example, palm tree is a small tree or a palm tree is a big tree. The word big or small is not judged as the data is not given. Nayagarh is a big city. We cannot say it is true or false as the data big is not well defined. So, when the sentence is not judged, hence it is not a big city. Indian cricket team is best in world. So, we are in confusion whether it is true or false. If a data is given, that the team which won 2 one days, three test series in a session in a year, or that is a good best 10. And the data of India is given. All cities are given. Hence we compare and say, as we satisfy the extent, so it is a statement. We write that Ramesh is a good student. How we know that it is Ramesh is a good student? In which condition we know? If data is not given, we say the student who secures 60% marks is a past student, which are good behavior, it is a past student, and it is not given, or that is called yardstick. If the it is not given, hence we say it is not a statement. So we know the following sentences are never statements, they are sentences. Next, statements are denoted by letters P, Q, R, S, like this. You know the notation of the statement, that the statement are denoted by letters P, Q or like this. Now, suppose we write P is a statement. P is a statement that ABC is a triangle. We write Q is a statement that sum of angles is 180 degree. We write two statements that P denotes that ABC is a triangle. Q statements means sum of angles is 180 degree. And we write ABC is a triangle. ABC is a triangle and sum of angles is 180 degree. We write ABC is a triangle and sum of angles is 180 degree. If ABC is a triangle, then sum of angles is 180 degree. We write that ABC is a triangle. ABC is a triangle if and only sum of angles are 180 degree. Now write, these are the compound statements. When two statements are joined with connectives and connectives if and only, then we form a single statement. That is called a compound statement. So compound statements are formed when two or more statements joined with connectives and form a single statements. So what is a compound statement? So compound statements are formed by joined with connectives and form a single statements. What are the connectives? And, if then, if and only, not, these are the connectives. Hence, a compound statement is a statement when two or more simple statements are joined by connectives. Connectives are, we write, one is AND. There is symbol of AND, OR, symbol OR, or that is equal to IF THEN. Symbol we write implies IF AND ONLY, IF AND ONLY, double implies NOT. So these are the symbol of connectives. Connectives are AND. That is, you write this symbol of connectives. Logically, we write it is conjunction. Conjunction. We write this is disjunction. And it is implication. implication or conditional, or it is a bio implication or bio conditional. Bio conditional. This is negation. So this is the logical name of the connectives. If two statements are joined by and, they form a single statement. Rama is son of Dasaratha. Lakman is son of Dasaratha. We write Rama is son of Dasaratha and Lakman is son of Dasaratha. We joined and. That is, we write conjunction. Logically we say it is conjunction. But as a symbol of conjunction, the symbol of disjunction or the symbol of implication. If ABC is a triangle, then sum of angles are 180. If you stand first in class, then I will give a prize. You stand first, one statement, and I will give a prize. This is another statement. They are joined by if then. If you stand first, then I will give a prize. So when we join if then, that is a form a single statement or a compound statement. That is implication. If and only x square is equal to 4, if and only if x is equal to 2. Or x is equal to 2, if and only if x square is equal to 4. X is equal to 3, if and only if x square is equal to 9. So right, this is biconditional or if and only. And this is not, means negation. So these are the logically named conjunction, disjunction, implication, biconditional and negation. Now, when two statements are joined by these connectives, they form a single statement called compound statement. So compound statements are expressed by two forms. Compound statements are formed by two ways, that is language form or symbolic form. A compound statement is expressed by two forms. One is language form, other is symbolic form. Suppose you write P is a statement that Rama went to market. And Q is a statement that Rama brought some books. So we take two statements and we write that Rama went to market and brought some books. Here it is a compound statement. It is in language form. We write P and Q. It is symbolic form. If P and Q is given and it is the language form. If language form is given, we write in symbolic form P and Q. P conjunction Q. If P conjunction Q is given, we write in language form. So a compound statement is expressed by two forms, either in language form or in symbolic form. If symbolic form is given, we write in language form. If language form is given, we write in symbolic form. Rama went to market or brought some books. We write P or Q. Rama went to market or brought some books. Hence we write symbolic form P or Q. If Rama went to market, then he brought some books. So it is P implies Q. If Rama went to market, then he brought some books. It is language form, P implies Q is symbolic form. Rama brought some books, if and only he went to market. That is the double implies Q. Rama brought some books. Even only he went to market. That is P, double implies Q. Rama went to market. Q is Rama brought some books. We take two statements, that Rama went to market and Q, Rama brought some books. And this is its language form. This is its symbolic form. If language form is given, so we can write its symbolic form. If symbolic form is given, we write its language form. If it is given that P and Q are given, and P double implies Q is given, it is symbolic form, like its language form. Hence we write, the Rama brought some books, if and only if he went to market. So it is symbolic form, it is language form. Hence we can convert language form to symbolic form to language form. In other classes, we study the rules and theorems of the logic, that is law of conjunction, disjunction, implication, biconditional, others. Thanks to all.